You all good, guys?
So we wanted to, we thought it would be a good idea, particularly coming up to the open, to talking about dealing with failure, because as I joked, you know, I really hope that test of weaknesses doesn't reveal any weaknesses I have, you know? We'll just get the surprise out of the way. It's going to, we're going to have noted something with a dumbbell, something with a barbell, something in our training and our programming that we've missed, something that we've let slip, that we haven't pushed ourselves hard enough on squats or burpees or handstand push-ups, and that's going to come up in the open, and it's a good idea to think about failure, what it means, what it actually is, and how we can deal with it. So we'll be right up here, like, Nye, Jordan, Fraser. Shell wanted to be in place of Jordan because she's a baller.
Yeah. We're the
same person. Same person. They all had epic failures. If you read Phil Knight's book, you'd hear about the times that Nike came so close to bankruptcy, the times their equipment manufacturing plan just cut them out. Banks getting out, kicking them out. Michael Jordan famously dropped from his basketball team in high school and then comes back, greatest player ever. Not many people here in Ireland play basketball, but we all know who Michael Jordan is. And then closer to home in our sport, Matt Fraser famously lost the CrossFit Games to Ben Smith when he just didn't try hard enough in his training for a year, came back and has just, you know, dominated the competition the last 2 years. In our own training, the cost of avoiding failure can be very, very high. So let's say we come into the gym and we're really good with the barbell or gymnastics, but I'll just use the barbell as an example. So we shy away from body mate movements and we're like, well, I'm strong, I'm just gonna squat, I'm just gonna deadlift and hit the Olympic lifts. Ultimately, if you just do that, your back squat is out, is gonna max out, and then it's like, okay, well now I'll just deadlift, snatch, and clean. And then your deadlift stops, and it's like, well, now I'll just snatch and clean, and then you just, you know, snatch, and then your window of ability just gets smaller and smaller, and your chance of injury gets higher because you're just doing the same pattern again and again. And that's ditto if you're good at gymnastics and you avoid the heavy barbell, or you're good at running and you avoid the days when it's heavy. You know that the more you allow yourself to shrink, the less room you have actually to develop, and the closer you are to getting an injury in a short term, long term, you're not gonna be as happy. So redefining failure. In the gym, we don't really have failures. We might think in the moment that it's an absolute failure, like, oh, I got my dumbbells overhead and I missed that lunge, you know? No real reason to have to stop and cry about it. You know, I know we can joke about it here, but it's always an opportunity to learn and grow. So we might come in today and we say, well, you know what, I didn't do the warm-up right. I didn't get my shoulders warmed up, for example. Or, okay, I do actually need to build my core. I hit failure, or my strategy was wrong. There's always an opportunity to turn it into a growth or a learning experience as well. But there are days, and we do admit it, and it might be during the open as well, where you really, really want to nail it, you know? You say, today's the day I'm going to get my bar muscle up, or my chest to bar, or I'm going to get that handstand push-up. And you just pile drive your head into the ground on your attempt at the handstand push-up. And that can be upsetting. We do admit we're all human, and while we have the lofty goal of being growth-minded, sometimes in the moment we can get it. Just reflect on it privately and move on. George Mumford, who is a famous mindfulness coach, he was Jordan's mindfulness coach, okay? Now, he came back from being a functional heroin addict to be coached to the best basketball dynasties in the world. So he's come back from failure. His expression is, don't bring the last play into the next one. So if you go for your snatch PR and you miss it, and then you go up to the bar again and go, I better not miss it, oh, that was so stupid. You're not really guaranteeing success there, you know? Park it, move on. That's not something that you can just do once. That's something you have to build and something you have to train. But you can train the ability to let failure go and move on. Most of this stuff, guys, comes from two books, one by Carol Dweck on mindset. She talks about growth versus fixed mindset. And the other one is Angela Duckworth on grit, if you want to check it out any further. All right? But failure is just nothing more than a chance to learn and grow from it. Thanks, guys.